first thing you should do is do a calibration. You can access it by pressing the button twice when the device starts, or you can go into its menu and do it whenever you want by rotating the encoder and going to self-test. Now you short the first two pins and the second with the third. So basically you short all three of them together. You lock the probes in and it's going to start some tests. When it says isolate probe, you need to disconnect them. And then it will ask you for a capacitor. I'm going to use the one that they provided, which is what they recommend. And I'm connecting it between the first and the third ports. Okay, and that's it. If you want to change the contrast, you can do it from the menu. And you need to long press. Okay. Let's do some tests and compare it to my multimeter, which is a 0.8% precision device. So let's see. So the multimeter says this is 0.471 kiloohms. And the transistor tester, well, it turns off to save battery. Let's try another. By the way, it doesn't matter which ports you connect the resistors to. Yeah, the test leads have a high resistance. So if you subtract that, you get the same value. Okay, let's try some capacitors. Let's try it on the multimeter. By the way, the transistor tester also shows you the ESR, which my multimeter doesn't. That is the equivalent series resistance. So this should be a 1 microfarad capacitor. It says 951. And the multimeter, let's see what the transistor tester says. Let's take a bigger one, like 47 micro. And in the multimeter, takes a while longer and it gives 50. Don't know why, but I kind of trust the transistor tester more. Let's use a really big one, like 10 milli. This might take longer on the transistor tester too. Okay. Let's see this big capacitor on the multimeter. I'm in the ohm range here. Yeah, my multimeter can't measure such a high capacitor. This is a 100 microhenries inductor. This is another inductor. Let's test some transistors. This is a 8050 NPN. Okay. An 8550 PNP. Let's try a MOSFET. an N-channel MOSFET. It also gives you the diode that's built into the MOSFET, if there is one. And the P MOSFET. I wonder what it will say about LM317 voltage regulator. I don't think it can measure this. Nope, it doesn't know what it is. This is a 1N4007 diode. Let's see what it can tell us about it. So it gives the voltage drop, the reverse current, and the capacitance. This is a BAT46 diode. Should have a much lower voltage drop. It's a Schottky diode. This is a potentiometer. This is the rest of the menu. We can go into transistor to check any device, not just transistors. So if I plug in this capacitor, well, I should do that again. Transistor testing, and it says it's a capacitor. This is where you can measure frequency. Unfortunately, I don't have a frequency generator, except this one, which is a frequency generator too. It can also generate a PWM signal. This is to measure capacitor ESR specifically. Between pins 1 and 3. Using this function, you can measure capacitor ESR in circuit. This should test the rotary encoder, but I don't know exactly how to use it. This is a self-test I showed you, contrast, and show data displays information about the device, about the transistor tester itself. These are the parts it can measure. Bipolar junction transistors, JFETs, IGBTs, MOSFETs, Triacs and Thyristors. Unfortunately, I don't have any. Diodes, resistors, inductors, and these are all the symbols it can display. And that's it. I'm very happy with the device. I think I'm going to use it quite often. Thanks for watching.